The focus of this lesson is on the square root function f of x equals square root of x, which is pictured here graphically. And we're going to go ahead and look at the different properties of this function, and particularly we're going to start with the domain. And so if you recall, a graph has a set of infinite points that are x comma y, and so when we talk about the domain, we're talking about the x-coordinates of the graph. And so if you look at the graph that's pictured here, you can see that it doesn't have any negative x-coordinates. In fact, it doesn't have an x-coordinate until you get to 0. And then as you move along, you can see that the positive x-coordinates do align with points on the graph. And so in other words, if you were to take your graph of f of x equals square root of x and project it down onto the x-axis, you would see that it starts at x is 0. And then if you continue to project it down, you would project it down forever in the positive direction. And so it's continuing out to positive infinity. And so the interval that we would use to represent that domain would start at 0, and it would include 0 itself. And so that's why we use a bracket to say that we're including the 0. And then it goes to positive infinity. And you never include positive infinity, so you would put a parenthesis. And so the domain goes from 0 to infinity, which is all the positive real numbers. Now for the range of the square root function, we would think from bottom to top. You know, again, range deals with the y-coordinates. So what y-coordinates are present on this graph? And as you can see, if we start here at the bottom in the negative values, there is no graph. In fact, we don't get to a graph until we get, again, to the y-value of 0. So starting here. And then as we go upward, we continue to hit graph, if you think about it. If you think about your graph projecting onto the y-axis, it continues and continues and continues to hit the higher and higher you go. It's because this arrow is indicating that the graph is going out to the right and up forever and ever. And so that takes us out to positive infinity. And so the interval is represented by the pink line that I'm drawing that starts at 0 and continues out to positive infinity. So we would say the range again includes the value of 0, hence the bracket, and goes to positive infinity. So again, it's all positive real numbers.